Hello, welcome back to Computer Network Lab. Yes, today I will discuss about the PBHs. I think some of you are knowing the PBHs. What is it? What is it using for? PBHs coming from private branch exchange. Okay. This PBH is the device or the software which provide the telephony, okay, telephony system. Nowadays PBH is very popular because all the companies, organizations, and some other private sectors, also the service provider, especially the operator of the mobile phone, they have the call center service because they will serve the customer for 24 hours, okay, 24/7. So this PBH is very useful for the system, okay. And the PBH is having two different types. One you can use the device, another one you can use the software. The software we call it soft PBH. Okay, let me show you one diagram. This is the soft VoIP, or we call it the soft PBH network diagram, or we just say that the telephony system. Okay, this telephony system, you can have computers, you can have smartphone, or you can have IP phone to communicate together. Okay, to communicate together. And this is the PBH server. This PBH server can be device, can be the computer installing software. The software is a PBH software. Okay, I will implement for you the Isabel. Okay, Isabel is one of the PBH server. Okay, is the platform is using Linux. Okay, so this video I will show you how to install the soft PBH on your computer. Okay, on my implementation I will use the VMware. Okay, VMware workstation. I have the software ISO file for Isabel. I have downloaded from the Isabel website. You can go to Isabel website. Okay. So when you come here, you go and create a new machine. Okay, and browse to your ISO file. Okay, browse to your ISO file. Open. Next, I just name my PBH. I can say PBH server. Okay, actually, I already have the VoIP PBH server. I already have a PBH, but I use another one. Is PBH server. And then the location wherever you want to store, it's up to you. You can browse it, but for my case, I stored it on Drive D. Okay, so after that, I click next. Okay, for the hard disk, you can choose as much as you can, because according to your hard disk, okay, can take. In my case, I have my dried D, I have two TB, so I don't have a problem with the space. So I can just take 120 GB and then I click next. Then I can customize my hardware. So the network adapter, I will use the bridge adapter, but I will show you later how to use the bridge adapter on VMware. And then I will switch this adapter to the bridge so that I can implement my calling from my Windows 10 client to another Windows client. Okay, so I will show you later, so just leave it and then click finish. Okay, now it installing the Isabel, so you move to the top install, press enter. Press any key to begin the installation process. You can press any key on your keyboard. It's the Linux base. Okay, if you familiar with Linux, so I think you don't have any problem. But during the installation, there will be a graphic. Okay, the graphic interface will be there. Do not worry about the installation. But the problem is after install, you need to use the command. Whatever you want to config, you use command. But this Isabel also gives you the web-based configuration as well. So I use English, United States, and I click continue. Okay, then I select keyboard. I have selected keyboard, but I need to select it again. Okay, the software selection, I will use Isabel version 11 of Asterisk. Okay, and then I check call center. I will implement call center for you also. So I need to check it right now. Okay, but if you don't want to use call center service, just leave it, do not check. But I will do the call center service. Okay, so I check it and I say done, and then it will check the source of the installation for software. It takes some time, and then choose the destination where you want to install all this software, all this OS. So click, I have 120 gigabyte, so I just click, and then I do not worry about the partitioning, so I just leave it automatic partitioning. Okay, so I say done, and then we can start to install now. During the installation, you can create your root password. Okay, so for my example, I will use the easy password. Okay, easy password. But for your real network, please put the secure password. Okay, remember, assign the secure password. But for my example, I will use 12345 as my password. 12345 as my password. Okay, again, please use the secure password. Okay, done. If you want to create another user, you can do it. Okay, but I don't want to use, I just use the root users. Okay, this root user is using for access to Isabel server using the shell. Okay, using the shell, no graphic. Okay, but there will be another username and password for log into the web base. It will be prompt later. Okay, it will be prompt later. So just wait for some time. Okay, it's almost done. It's almost done. It will be prompt another username and password for the database and for the especially for the web login. Okay. Do not worry if you don't know how to use the command of the line notes, you can use web base. Okay, it's very easy. Okay, it's rebooting. Okay, this is the database password. I also use 12345, but again, please use a secure password. Enter 12345, repeat the password. Okay. Yes, here is the password for web login. Okay, so I'll also using 12345. 12345. Just a testing password. Okay, please use the secure password. Because you know the security issue is very important nowadays. We are almost done of the installing PBH. Yeah, here is the login username is the root, password is 12345. When you type the password, it won't show any character here. Okay, please do not confuse. When you type the password, it won't show any character. Enter. Oops. What happened? Root password 12345. Okay, now our installing PBH server is finished, so we will see the next video with the configuration of the server. The first configuration will be networking, so that you can log in from your web browser. Okay, so I think that's all for this video. So thank you, and please do subscribe.